Hey everybody, Matt LaPlante here again. Got another video for you. This one is in the Ask Matt series, and this one is going to be on the Secure Act that, if you're not aware, it passed back on, like, technically it was signed by Trump and became a law on December 20th of 2019, so last year. And really, I'm just going to hit on a few different things that I think affect the majority of people. There are some other aspects whether for business owners, so if you're one of those people and would like to know more about that, feel free to give me a call or shoot me an email and I can go over some of those with you. But most of it is going to affect what I would say is the retired is probably the first one, those who have kids in college, and those who are considering having kids are the three areas that are probably going to be affected the most or see some impact as a result of this. So we'll start with the retired. So for those of you who are approaching 70 and a half, or were in 2019, you got a little bit of a benefit out of this Secure Act. So those of you who aren't aware, if you have a traditional IRA, you can put your money in and it can grow tax-free until you pull it up, then you got to pay your taxes. Well, the age that the government said you have to start pulling money out of that was 70 and a half. Sounds a little strange, the date or the age, but it was 70 and a half. You had to start doing what are called required minimum distributions, RMDs. And so the Secure Act, what they did was they said, no longer is it gonna be 70 and a half. We're gonna allow you to wait if you so desire. You don't have to start taking the RMDs, required minimum distributions, until you turn 72. So who this affects: if you turn 70 and a half in 2019, you still have to do the RMDs based on your life expectancy. If you turn 70 and a half after that, so you don't have to start worrying about it until you turn 72. So after, in 2020 on, is when you have to start worrying about RMDs when you turn 72. Now, that's nice that you had added an extra year and a half of time that you don't have to worry about it. But here was the kicker. They gave you a little something there, but they also took it away from your heirs. And so for those of you who are familiar, who maybe inherited an IRA from a parent or something like that, or grandparent maybe, you may have been taking advantage of something called the Stretch IRA. And so what the Stretch IRA did, the Stretch IRA allowed you to take the required minimum distributions based on your life expectancy. So you were pulling out less, a smaller amount. It could continue to grow over your life expectancy rather than your parents, who may have been 80 when they passed away. And so you had to take out large chunks. So it's a little convoluted, but just to let you know, the Stretch IRA is gone. If you're using a Stretch IRA in 2019, you're fine. If you weren't employing the Stretch IRA strategy and we're now in 2020, it's gone. You can't utilize it anymore. That was the give and take that they did for the RMD rules. So you got 72 now to start taking RMDs, but you no longer have the Stretch IRA over your lifetime. Now it's just over the next 10 years you have to start. You have to withdraw the entirety of the IRA that you inherited. So again, if you're in in one of those situations, you have a question, give me a call, shoot me an email, we'll go over it to kind of go over the details for your personal situation. Number two, the one that deals with parents who may have kids, and kids in particular, they're going to college. One nice thing, this is probably the happy side of this law, was that parents, if you were contributing to kids 529 plan, which is kind of like an IRA, you were just putting it away for your kids' education. You could put it into the 529, as long as you pull it out for qualified educational expenses, whole list of those things, then you're able to pull it out tax-free. Well, until just recently, you weren't able to pull it out to pay for student loan debt. No longer. Now you can pull out up to $10,000 per year to pay off student loan debt of your kids. So hey, that's a good thing. You can save a little bit of money there, and hopefully that'll be beneficial for some. Last but not least, there was a new thing for those of you who are expectant, expecting to be parents or considering adopting. There's a new portion of the law that came out that said now you can pull out up to $5,000 from your 401k and you don't have to pay a penalty. Now, that's good, but not great. Here's why. So you don't have to pay a penalty. The penalty was 10%. You had to pay 10% plus the taxes that you owed. Well, the law says you just don't have to pay the penalty. So you're still going to have to pay the taxes on whatever you happen to, potentially. You may still have to pay the taxes. So you're going to want to consult with your with whoever does your taxes. But hopefully that's a happy part of this law, is that for those of you who are considering having children or are looking to adopt, that this may be a benefit for you. So again, these are just the top three things from the Secure Act that that passed that I think will affect the majority of people. There are some things, again, with small business owners and whether or not if you decide to set up a retirement plan. So if you have questions about that or any of the stuff that I went over, don't hesitate. Give me a call or shoot me an email. I'll go over it with you. It's not a big law, but typically there's things that are in the nitty-gritty of the law as it passes. There may be some different quirks and things that we don't know about. So as I get more details and as more information comes out, if there's any hidden gems that I find in there, I'll be sure to make another one. But until next time, guys, I'll talk to you then.